Dear students, let us continue the module 3. In the module 3, we are studying the third chapter, that is the process control. So in this video, we will be discussing the three topics, that is VFORC function, WAIT and WAIT PID functions, WAIT 3 and WAIT 4 functions. So let us see the first topic, that is the VFORC function. Just now in the previous video we saw fork function. So fork function, what does it do? It will create a child process and it will return zero value to the child process, and process ID of the child process will be returned to the parent process. This is what it happens when a process executes the fork function. So the function, but here in the VFORC, the function VFORC has the same calling sequence and same return values as fork. Here also VFORC also creates the child process. It returns 0 to the child process and returns process ID of the child process to the parent process. The VFORC function is intended to create a new process when the purpose of new process is to execute a new program. When the purpose of the creating a new child process is to process the execute function for a new program. We will suppose we have a new program to be executed, then we can create a child process. The VFORC function creates a new process. It creates a new process just like fork without copying the address space of parent into the child. Using the fork function, what used to be there? The child process used to run in the same address space of the parent process. But here it is not like that. A VFORC doesn't allow the child process to copy the address space of the parent process. As the child won't reference that address space, the child simply calls execute or exit right after the VFORC. So right after the VFORC, child process can call execute function or exit function. So instead, while the child is running and until it calls either execute or exit, the child runs in the address space of the parent. So until the child is running or it is calling execute or exit function, child will be running in the same address space of the parent process. Another difference between the two functions is that VFORC guarantees that the child runs first until the child calls execute or exit. So another thing is there, that VFORC allows the child process to run first, and it allows the parent process to execute until it calls the execute or exit function. When the child calls either of these functions, the parent resumes. Once the child process calls either of these two functions, then only the parent process will resume execution. Next topic is WAIT and WAIT PID functions. So when WAIT and WAIT PID function is used, when a process terminates, once the process finishes its work and it wants to terminate, so when a process terminates, either normally or abnormally, the kernel notifies the parent by sending the SIG child signal to the parent. So the parent, the kernel will, once the child process terminates, the kernel will send a signal called sigchild to the parent process, and it will notify the parent process that child process is terminated. Because the termination of the child is an asynchronous event, termination of the child is an asynchronous event. Anytime it can happen. It can happen at any time while the parent is running or sleeping or executing. And this signal is the asynchronous notification from the kernel to the parent. So So this signal can come any time to the parent process. Now it depends on the parent process how it will handle the signal. The parent can choose to ignore this signal. It has three options. Either it can, parent process can ignore the signal, or it can provide a function that is called when the signal handler, or it can provide, or parent process can also, on receiving of the sick child signal, parent process can also provide a function that is called when the parent process can call a function that is called the signal handler, which will handle the signal. A process that calls wait or wait PID can block if all its children are still running. If a process has called the wait or wait PID function, then it will block itself if all the children are still running. Return immediately with the termination status of the child. If a child has terminated and is waiting for its termination status to be fetched, it can return the status of the child. Other thing can happen. It return immediately with an error if it does not have any child process. If the process doesn't have any child process, then it will return immediately with an error. The prototype of the wait and wait PID function are PID underscore t wait integer star stat lock, and PID underscore t wait PID PID underscore t PID integer star stat lock comma integer options. Both returns process ID if okay. Both will return the process ID who has called the wait function, or 0 or 1, minus 1 on error. It will also return, it can return minus 1 on error. Another two functions which we have is wait 3 and wait 4 functions. So the only feature provided by these two functions that is not provided by wait or wait PID function is an additional argument that allows the kernel to return a summary of resources used by the terminated process and all its child process. As you know that when the wait function is called, it will block the process. Then, but when a wait 3 or wait 4 function has some extra arguments. So when wait 3 or wait 4 are called, then summary of the resources will also be provided to the terminated process. So here prototype is PID underscore t wait 3 integer stat star stat lock and integer options and struct r usage. So these are r usage are nothing but usage of the resources, and PID underscore t wait 4. So PID underscore t PID integer star stat lock integer options and struct r usage. So here in wait 4, 4 arguments are there, but wait 3, 3 arguments are there. So wait 3 and wait 4, it provides the usage information of the usage by a process to resources. It provides the usage of resources to the terminated process. So this is all about wait 3 and wait 4 functions. So we will wind up the class here. The next video we will continue the race condition. Thank you.